Look, before we get into the content, it's really important that you guys hit that subscribe button. We're out here every single day working for y'all, trying to hit y'all with the best content. And what motivates us to keep going is people like you. So hit the subscribe button, join the conversation, join the Deuce Gang.
What he said.
I've said some blunt things about Shikari. That's her name, Shikari. I've said some pretty blunt things about Shikari, about her idiotic life choices, or maybe just the one, and she paid for that, right? But the one thing that I like, because we are so used, I'm talking about us as a people now, we are so used to tearing each other down. There can only be one. There can only be one. When 50 Cent and Ja Rule were running around, they couldn't both coexist. There could only be one. We are used to tearing each other down. But when Shikari Wilson was down and out, and that's a little bit of a, you're going to see where I'm going with that, down and out in a moment. When she was down and out, it was one of us who helped prop her back up, or at least started to push her, I think, in the right direction. What am I talking about? Somebody's leg. And those are some interesting shoes. But again, let's get into this. You think she runs with those on? I'm talking about those ankle bracelets.
Oh yeah, definitely, 100%. Have you seen her nails? For sure.
Okay. I just want to point that out. We'll get there.
Right, right.
Back again, I use my back against the wall. Never caught on y'all. Never count on y'all. Always count on God. He's done miracles on me.
Edges are laid.
He's done miracles on me.
Jeez.
He's done miracles on me.
They got like multiple toothbrushes for that one.
Oh, absolutely.
He's done miracles on me. He's done miracles on me.
Yeah, that
studio butts.
That right there kind of says it all. Kanye West, Dr. Dre say, hey, I see you down and out. I got you. And what a way to be propped up. The long-awaited Donda. You get incorporated in some sort of a promo with that, as well as a Beats. Beats has been around forever, whatever. But I have my opinion on this. What say you? Wait. Subscribe. Hit the subscribe button. What say you?
I mean, that was important, but that was a good way to just squeeze it in there. I mean, I'll just listen. Congratulations to Shikari for doing what she did and getting this big deal. I'm not going to knock anybody for securing their bag, but you know where I'm going with this. If you don't, I'm going to let you know where I'm going with this. It follows along with the previous video where we spoke about her before, and I said that there's a possibility that she might have gotten high on purpose, knowing that more opportunities would come from the infamy of her breaking the rules and not being able to run than her actually running the race and possibly not winning, because she wasn't a guaranteed winner. So it's funny that this comes up so quickly. She gets this deal, and I'm not surprised that she did. That she got the deal at all. I mean, she is a great athlete. I'm not going to take away from her talent at all. But this check that she's collecting off of this, I'm wondering if, think about where she's going to be at 4 years from now. If she's collecting checks like this, she's going to be bigger and better in 4 years. So was it worth it smoking the weed?
Look, really the main question that I have is, would she have gotten this endorsement if none of that ever happened? Like, if she was just good to go, raring to go, would Kanye have reached out? Would Beats have reached out? That's really what I'm curious about. Again, to be clear, I love the fact that we helped a sister up when she was down. Now, we don't know if any of these other white companies have been knocking on her door. We don't know. We just
She'd be running at the Olympics right now if she didn't get disqualified, right? So she wouldn't be doing this. So, I mean.
Okay, fine. That's an excellent point. Now, let's take her out of the Olympics. Let's just say. Boom. So, you understand what I'm saying? Like, do you think
I get where you're going with it.
Right. And again, like, I don't want to make it sound like these white corporate companies aren't going to be, we don't know. She could be in a Gap commercial tomorrow for all we know. Right. But what I'm saying though, is if this didn't happen, that horrible, horrible life changing decision, if it didn't happen, would she be in this commercial? I don't know if she would.
If she had got really, really, really drunk. Do you think she would have got this commercial?
No, she wouldn't have, because our community, although we enjoy drinking, although we do drink even in excess to the point where we get lit and do stupid things, like you've seen it, it's documented. We don't celebrate alcohol the same way that we do weed. Like, when you listen to hip hop, when you listen to urban music, weed is way more celebrated than alcohol. I'm not an idiot. Of course there's songs about liquor. Hello. I'm just stating the obvious that weed is much more celebrated than alcohol in our music. If she got blackout drunk and did some dumb stuff and got disqualified, I don't think Kanye and Dre would have reached out.
I mean, anybody wondering why my guy right here is bringing up the fact alcohol, because in case you don't remember, the reason that she said she smoked weed in the first place was to deal with the loss of her mother. So
condolences,
of course.
R.I.P.
One of the things that we spoke about in the other video, or actually this guy brought up in the other video, was why there's other things that she could have tried that were possibly legal and could have helped her cope, such as maybe she could have went out and just had sex with a bunch of people. Maybe she could have went out and got really, really drunk. Like, maybe there's other things she could have do, but she chose to smoke weed knowing of all the things, this would definitely get her to, it'd be like, yo, I feel like I'm just going to snort this line right now just to deal with this pain. Like, you know, the consequences of it. But with that being said, like I said in the video before, she probably has some people behind her ear saying, listen, you might not win this. You might not. So let's see what else we can get you with some money behind it. And this is just the kicker. We'll see what else happens from this, because apparently she has two commercials.
Oh,
there's another commercial that should be coming out. I don't know when that one's playing. I think that's during the Olympics sometime or something like that. But I heard that she has another commercial, apparently. I'm not sure if it's with Beats as well, but.
Well, Shikari?
Shikari. I've heard it Shikari. I've heard people say Shikari. So I need to find an interview with her in it saying her name.
Thank you. Shikari. Really? Salute to you. You get in the bag. Stupid, dumb decision. But guess what? People have made stupid, dumb decisions. That's stupid and dumb mean the same thing. But people have made those types of decisions where it actually worked out for the better. So hey, maybe
she wouldn't be the first person, for real.
So maybe this is one of those things. But listen, viewing public, one stupid or dumb, that's like, are we finished or are we done? Well, one stupid or dumb decision that I don't want you to make is, I don't want you to reach this far in the video and not hit that subscribe button or that like button. You're this far already. Click the button, join the Deuce gang, and be proud of yourself. But with that being said, let's keep it on.
Oh, so hold on. They got a comment too, though, man. Tell them to comment too. Let them know. You know, be part of the comments, the conversation, because that's what the main part of this channel is, conversation. We definitely want you to click that like button, but we want a whole conversation, see how you feel about the topic. So definitely let us know how you feel about the topic with Shikari right here. Do you feel like, you know, it's a proud moment? We should be praising her and continue to praise her, even though she made this mistake. Or do you believe that she needs to be held accountable? And like, some people need to be like, all right, let's slow down on just giving her a bunch of money for smoking some weed out here. I mean, let us know that too. Let us know.
And again,
sorry, go ahead.
And again, she wouldn't be the first person to get a bunch of money for smoking.
Wouldn't.
Some weed.
No, but, no. But hopefully not the last. Two guys are right here waiting for that. Hey, cannabis people out there, man, we waiting for you. Trust me. Well, I'm waiting.
More so probably. Comments and make sure to join the Deuce Gang. But let's keep it athletic. You sent me over some content a little bit earlier today. I'd like you to take the reins.
I got you on this, man. Don't worry. I know. And the reason that he's doing that is because he knows so much that he doesn't want to come off as like a brainiac. So he passes it off to me. And listen, this guy, I appreciate that, man. I appreciate you. Okay. Let's go on with the story.
Oh my God.
So for those who are unaware, the Milwaukee Bucks are officially the NBA champions. This is their first championship in 50 years. The last time they won was actually so long ago that Kareem Abdul-Jabbar's name was still Lou Alcindor. So that, I just thought that was interesting.
listen. If you're a Bucks fan and you're celebrating, hit that subscribe button, man. Hit that subscribe button.
For sure. Okay, Oscar Robinson also played for the team, so it's their first in a long time. But the main topic here are the crazy, crazy stat lines for Giannis. And I don't mean in the game. I mean his career so far. Giannis is 26 years old. Listen to this list of awards, okay? Listen to this. Check this out. 2021 NBA champion, 2021 NBA Finals MVP. He has two NBA MVPs from 2019 and 2020. He has an NBA Defensive Player of the Year award. He has five NBA All-Star appearances. He's been an NBA All-Star Game MVP. He got the Most Improved Player in 2017. And he's had five All-NBA selections, with three of them being all NBA first team. Okay, the other two are second team. The man is 26 years old. If I gave you that stat line, I didn't tell you his age. Is this Hall of Fame? Do you think this is Hall of Fame, what I'm telling you in your mind?
I would think that those accolades are of someone who's been playing for at least maybe 8 years, 10 years.
Yeah, I wouldn't put that past that at all, because it's the fact that this guy came in and wasn't the player that he was and worked his way to it. And another big thing is that his brother, his real brother, is actually also on the Milwaukee Bucks.
Oh, that's dope.
And got a chance to enjoy the championship with him as well. It's pretty cool, right?
That's sick.
I didn't get the chance to look into it, but I wanted to see if they were the first brothers to win a ring together. I wanted to see if that's true, because if that's true too, add it to the list, right?
That's pretty
let me
dope.
Tell you some of the little bit of controversy that we have here, right? So there's a few things that people are talking about, and I want to see your opinion on this, right? So Chris Paul was on the Phoenix Suns, Hall of Fame himself, legendary career stats, but people have been talking for a long time that he, for lack of a better term, can't finish. He gets all the way to the end and it goes dull again.
A lot of people have that problem.
There's unfortunately not a pill for this, though, what he was talking about. I just realized what it sounded like. That's great. That's all horrible right. On my point. It's just natural for me now. But do you think, okay, so Chris Paul right now, his numbers are crazy. Multiple NBA all-time. You know his name. People know who he is right now. Do you think that a player, if you're an athlete, that it is a requirement for you to win a championship to be considered a legend?
In a word, yes. Nobody.
So anybody who doesn't have a ring to you is not considered a legend.
Nobody gets into anything competitive without the goal of being the best and leaving their mark, whether it's hip hop, whether it's any type of athletics, anything, even just being a teacher. You want your mark felt. So again, yes, in a word, yes.
I mean, this is how I'll put it for in another way. It's hard to be considered a legendary artist if you didn't have a number one Billboard song, right? It's hard to be considered the number one app if you're not the most downloaded app, at any point. It's hard to be considered the number one business if you're not making the most amount of money.
This is what I'm saying.
There's just, I feel like there's certain things that are requirements. And as much as I love Chris Paul and his career, I think that him not winning this, especially after the lead they had, definitely does tarnish his rep, right? But they want to put an asterisk on the Milwaukee Bucks championship. They don't want to consider this an official championship. Like the Raptors, they want to put an asterisk.
Yeah.
It's just like the Raptors. You know, remember, they want to put an asterisk beside the Raptors.
Right.
And it's along the same lines, because they're saying, because the season started back so soon, a lot of other players were hurt. A lot of other players were injured and they weren't ready to go, and they got hurt because it came back so soon. So a lot of the superstars that should have been playing late in the season weren't. Kawhi Leonard, gone. ACL tear. LeBron James had a significant injury. Anthony Davis had a significant injury. These guys were all gone for multiple things. These are champion the teams that were in the end that I'm talking about, of course. Like, praise to all the other injuries, but just I'm talking about the main ones that concern these things that we're talking about directly, right? So they're saying if the NBA had probably started off, these guys were healthy, Milwaukee probably wouldn't have won a championship. The same thing they try to do to the Raptors. Do you think you could take away somebody's championship based on injuries?
Look, man, at the end of the day, I understand the criticism. I do. Because ultimately, winning a championship, getting to the finals, 7-game series, that's not supposed to be no easy feat. It's not. Going platinum when you're releasing an album, when all the other top tier artists are doing that, it's not supposed to be no easy. It's just not. It's supposed to be difficult. But it doesn't take away from the fact that you won a championship. It doesn't take away from the fact that you went platinum. You still did it. So I understand the criticism. I do. Hey, you got lucky. It was easier this time around. Let's see you do it next year when everybody's... And that's all it is. And look, man, even if you play for this team, the Bucks, congratulations to you. Tip my hat. Even if you play for this team, even you would have to admit that the fact that some of these key players were out made it a little bit easier. Even you would have to admit that. Bro, when I used to play House League sports and we play year round, the same people show up and all that, you get to know the people on the team. And when the big dude doesn't show up, the guy that can hit the ball the farthest, the best shooter, the guy who can actually dunk, because you remember him from the previous games, you're like, yes. What are we talking about here? So now
it definitely makes it easier if the star players aren't there. I'll give you that.
Yeah, for sure.
That goes without saying. LeBron James and Anthony Davis not being on the Lakers is a worse team. It's easier team to play against, right? But you still got to go in as a team and execute. You can't go in as a team and relax. A lot of teams have a tendency to go into these situations and relax and not beat these teams. They sneak up whatever. So the reason why I give still praise to these guys winning the championship as well, and I don't put an asterisk beside it, is because one thing that I don't think a lot of people consider, because maybe you don't really play sports, you're just sitting on the couch criticizing, is the focus it requires to become a championship.
Right.
To become a champion. The focus, the mental focus, when all this other stuff is going on in your own personal life, between your team, yes, the other team has their own injuries, but you still, as a team, as a cohesive, have to remain focused. And loss of focus, the perfect example to show what happens when you lose your focus, is exactly what happened to the Phoenix Suns. They were up in the series 2-0, heavily focused, because the desire was there, and then another team just got more focused and came back. And then that's the only difference between this right here. So asterisks, you want to put asterisks on the Raptors? You want to put it on Milwaukee Bucks? That's fine. You can do that. But like I said, you're probably sitting at home on your couch and you don't understand what it takes. So that's my hot take on that point.
Nah, man, it's an excellent point, because at the end of the day, both teams are still there. Both teams are still in the finals. Now it's about who wants it more.
Like, how are you going to talk to these guys? Like, these guys are making hundreds of millions of dollars a year, you know what I mean, to play this sport, and they're dedicating their lives. Like, they're getting a lot of money to do this. There's a lot of pressure to feel like you're earning that money, even though they're getting it regardless. There's a lot of pressure to feel like you're doing something that's worthwhile for your team. You know what I'm saying? Like, if you get that much money, you got to do something with it. You know what I mean?
That's a really, really good point, man. I mean, imagine that being the finals, series is tied up, game is tied up, you get a technical shot. It's in your hands.
The game is in your hands.
That is a lot of pressure, right? I'm just trying to basically put this.
Especially if you're the number one guy, you're getting all that stuff there. You know what I mean? So
in everyone's mind, they're like, this is a wrap. He's definitely going to hit this. This is why these things take it back to the soccer game with the racists and the death threats. And people get passionate with it, man. But I don't want to go on a tangent with that. But asterisks, I agree. No asterisks needed. They won the championship. It may have been a little bit of an easier time this season. Let's see what they do with it next year when everybody's supposed to be healthy. Viewing public, What are your thoughts, man? Milwaukee Bucks, I know you guys are celebrating. I know you guys are going crazy. Go crazy. Hit that subscribe button because we want to celebrate too. That's all I'm saying.
Hey, I want to know personally, do you think Chris Paul's legendary status is at risk right now? Like, because he didn't win the championship and like, you think Giannis is already Hall of Fame? He might be already, man. That's crazy. He's a $100 million man himself, you know? And speaking of $100 million men, you sent me an article of somebody who just entered the $100 million club through donation. What's going on over here? What's going on?
Oh, my man, Van Jones.
Okay.
Listen, man.
My segue caught you off guard, eh? It caught you off guard.
Yeah, a little bit.
But it was silky. That's how I'll take it.
But no, it was actually really dope. But the reality is we talk, well, I know I do anyways. I talk a lot of smack about the billionaires, but Bezos did something ill, man. He did something ill. He gave Van Jones $100 million to donate to his charity or the charity of his choice. I'm paraphrasing here, but Van Jones was like, I didn't even know what to say.
Yeah,
I mean, like, think about how would you react if somebody put 100 M's in your hand and say, here you go, man. You are amazing. We need more strong voices like you.
That, I mean, there was no conversation. There's no conversation before. Like why? I want to know why Van, not just to discredit Van Jones, but what conversation was had between Van Jones or what did Jeff Bezos see in Van Jones? Because there has to be something about him himself or what he's doing that Bezos feels, you know, attached to in some way. This is not McDonald's. Well, listen, for him, this is McDonald's money. But for a regular human being, this is not McDonald's money. You know what I mean? This is a lot of cash to give to somebody.
Well, I mean, at the end of the day, Van Jones, he's, I don't want to call him an activist, but he's definitely an advocate for the underprivileged. He, whenever he sees an injustice, he speaks, he has a really big platform. His voice is very respected, and he uses his voice to shed light and speaks very passionately on things that may not get that attention, on very uncomfortable topics. He speaks to that. And again, he's into philanthropy. So I don't want to say anything negative about the 100 M's and what's going to happen on Bezos' side around tax time. I don't want to go there.
Nah, forget about that. Let's focus on the good stuff. I just don't know a lot about Van Jones. Like, me personally, just being honest. So that's why I was just curious as to why of all the people that to me, he's a news broadcaster.
Mm-hmm.
Right. He's a CNN correspondent.
Right.
Why are we giving him $100 million for charity? That's why I'm not saying it's a bad thing. Listen,
oh,
guys,
I know
I'm
you're
not
just
saying
asking.
It's a bad thing.
You're just asking.
I'm really curious. I really want to know, and probably I'm going to look into what Van Jones is into because it must be really good. It has to be.
Yeah, I mean, at the end of the day, like, if you want to really and truly, what I think this is again, just to quickly speak to Van Jones. If you give Van Jones 100 M's to donate it, in my opinion, could be wrong. Viewing public, do share your thoughts. But if you give Van Jones $100 million to donate to a charity, I believe that the right charities, not saying there's any wrong ones, but I believe that the right charities are going to get that money. Now, with that being said, Bezos could have did this himself.
Disagree. And you're never going to get me ever to disagree with what Jeff Bezos' decisions are. And I always have an explanation for what they are. Because if you don't know how to do something, you find somebody who does know how to do it, and you give them the resources to get it done.
No, I guess really what I'm saying is Bezos has a staff. He could say, hey, I have 100. By the way, he donated $200 million. He gave another 100 M's to somebody else, but we're talking about Venn. But Bezos has a staff. He could have been like, hey, I got this money. I want to donate it. Bring me a list of charities. Give me some bullet points, et cetera, et cetera. I'll make my decision. He didn't want to do that. So the reason why I think he went the route he went, he's a showman. He just came from freaking space. He's got the spotlight on him. He just told the entire world, you paid for my flight to space. Kind of an asshole move. But hey, don't worry, world. Here's $200 million to charity. You're welcome. That's what I think.
It's the truth. The people, Amazon people and the staff, you help pay for the trip. And that's the truth. Mm-hmm. So I see nothing wrong with him saying that. I believe that if it was between me choosing between the Amazon executives and Van Jones, and I'm Bezos, like I'm actually Jeff Bezos, and I can choose between my staff or a guy who's has a history of doing what he does, I'm going to choose the guy who has the history of doing what he does.
Exactly.
You know what I mean? Just because for the right reasons, but if we're going to talk about the little slight reasons, it's also because I don't want to do the wrong thing with the money, right? And if the wrong thing does get done, it's not my fault. I gave it to Van Jones.
Oh, my God. Listen.
I had to do at least one.
I know you
I had did. To do at least. I had to be at least one. At least one billionaire mindset
thing. Listen, viewing public, what are your thoughts here? I mean, honestly, Van Jones got handed $100 million. I'm not saying I'm a Van Jones expert. You know, we're gonna do our own little dig and try to figure out where this money might go. Leave it in the comments. Where do you think Van Jones is gonna spend this money? What would your reaction be if he handed you $100 million to donate? And really, would you take a little bit of that money for yourself, maybe like a finder's fee or some shit like that? I don't know. But let us know what your thoughts are. Leave it in the comments. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Join the Deuce Gang.
Hey,
peace.
Deuces.
All right.
Oh, yo, let me say something else before you stop recording. Hold on. So I did something the other day. Okay. And I'm going to need your assistance on this. I want this to be taped. So do not stop the tape. Okay. I want people to see how much of a genius you are. Okay. So I got a program. Don't ask me what the letters stand for, but it's called OBS Studio.
Okay.
What the program does is allows you to record YouTube videos and yourself at the same time and the audio and everything. So pretty much you can do the little reaction videos. You can do videos with different content on a different screen, or, you know, you can split screens and stuff like that.
Sick.
So I did that because, you know, we've been speaking about it for a long time. You've been saying, you know, my guy, why don't you go out there, try to do something a little bit different, see if you can do your own content. You know what I mean? So I actually got the program.
Nice.
I watched the YouTube video. Okay. I set it up. I did myself, you know, doing a little reaction to Catch a Predator.
Nice.
I watched it back. And it was horrible, man. I need advice. You are good with the camera. You know what you're doing. You've been doing it for a while. So when I'm on camera and I'm doing these videos, How do I draw people's attention? What do I got to do, man? Give me some advice, seriously.
Seriously?
Yo, I'm being dead ass. I'm being so serious right now. Like we're on the phone having a phone conversation. Like only this is recorded.
It's really straightforward.
Okay.
You're a pretty honest person, and I think you have some pretty good comedic timing. It's really just playing the video, and whatever comes to your mind. That's stupid. Why did they do this? How could they do that? Why did she say this? Hit pause, say your thought, keep it going. That is it.
Serious?
That is
I think I might be it. I might be overthinking it.
You
maybe
are
I might
100%
be overthinking. You already know me.
100%. The reality is anybody who scrolls through their social media, anybody who watches YouTube, even this video right now, they have an opinion. It could be a good one. It could be a negative one. They could be verbalizing it. They could be saying it in their head. So the reaction video, those types of videos, they do so well because it's a real thing. It's a it's a reaction. So all you need to do is just be honest in your reaction. Guarantee there's going to be people that feel the same way as you. I mean, it might be corny the first couple of times, but it takes time. After a while, you'll get into your rhythm. You'll get into your flow. You'll know yourself, just like Drake say. And then you'll be fine. Flow.
I like that. Yeah, I like that movie.
And then you'll be fine. It just takes time. At the end of the day, you can't be critical because even if it's whack, even if somebody says it's whack, the person who's saying it's whack, search them on YouTube. I guarantee you they don't have one reaction. I guarantee you they haven't posted anything. So that's the difference between us and them. You can make all the comments you want, but we're out here actually doing it. You're not. So that's how much weight. That's how much weight we put into your criticism. Some of it is constructive and it's appreciative, but if you're if you're just here to slander, where's your work at? What are you doing? That's all I'm saying.
Well, we'll see how it goes. You know, I'm gonna try it out a few times. I'm pretty sure I'm just watching it be super critical, overly critical of myself or whatever. But I mean, I only did one thing and it was like for like 3 minutes, nigga, just to see if it worked really. So
nigga, put the damn video viewing public. If you want to see the content, leave it in the comments, give us some likes. I won't even ask you to sub, just leave it in the comments or give us some likes. If you
want to
see,
maybe put that at the beginning so that people actually, I want people to actually, if they want to see this, I really, really want to see if people want to see this type of content for real. So I don't know if this is going to be the clip for, I don't care, man. I really want people to, I really want to know. Cause I don't know. I feel like it'll be great. I feel like it'll be dope if I do this type of content and I do like remote location content too, where I go to different locations and try different things, interview different people and stuff like that. But if nobody wants to see it, I mean, what am I doing it for? So I guess we'll see if people like this.
Let us know. Don't forget to join the Deuce Gang. Deuces. All right.
Cool. Hey, yo, thanks for watching that video, making it all the way to the end. You made it this far. You have to like, please subscribe and comment on the video as well. Join the conversation.
Absolutely. We finally hit our goal of 500 subscribers. Yes we are trying to get to 1,000. And we can only do that with your help. You can start by watching that next video. You see that tiny little icon? Click on that icon, rinse and repeat. Deuces.
Deuces.